ocean is my playground. My family moved here in 66, and to grow up in the ocean, to blessed to have Mavericks. And the ocean is alive. The ocean's got no conscience as well, and you got to really listen to your instincts.
Any wipeout of Mavericks can be your last.
You got rocks, sharks, massive amounts of water, cold water too, but that's another part of it. I mean, the water in the wintertime ranges from 52 to 54 degrees, so you're wearing all this rubber. You got booties and gloves and hoods and, I mean, all of that, you know. In Hawaii, you get to wear just board shorts, you know, and you've got lifeguards. To be perfectly honest, the people telling me that I was the best out there, that's great. That's great, but I never felt that.
Times at Mavericks where I really thought that was it, you know. My leash got caught on the rocks and basically thinking, God, just a couple more waves and I'm gonna die.
Mavericks is a unique wave in the sense that it's in one of the perfect proximities on the coast of California, which anytime you ever go surf a place that's as deadly as a wave like Mavericks, it's like a maritime law in a way. You always are looking out for each other.
These are 18 feet great whites with big teeth, and they will bite your body in half with one bite. The true story of Mavericks is way heavier than any Hollywood movie could imagine.
A love for everyone and everything, and he was able to do that, and I learned a lot from him. And how could something like that happen to him?
I was on my knees and I was praying and just